What's going on, guys? Nick Griffin here, pastor of One Church Port Orange. In collaboration with all the One Churches across Central Florida, in collaboration with all the One Church Collective throughout Florida, in collaboration with all those who call on the name of Christ Jesus, the universal church who are submitted under the authority and the supremacy of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. You know, we're doing a part of a 21-day prayer and fasting. And I've been super challenged even on this morning because you see, I lost my wallet. I can't find my wallet. I can't find my identity anywhere. And I think the fear of losing your wallet is the fear that somebody else will find it, will find the core essence of who you are, all your personal information, and they're gonna mismanage it in a way that would not be to your benefit. So I find myself this morning in travail, just really trying to find it, searching for it. This thing had me so filled with anxiety. I'm opening up like boxes. I haven't even opened up these boxes in like 20 years. And I'm thinking, man, maybe my wallet's in there. Maybe my wallet's in there. Why would I put my wallet in there? I don't know. But losing my identity is driving me crazy. It brings me back to this verse where Paul says, I am crucified with Christ, but nevertheless I live, yet not I, but it's Christ who lives in me, and the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God, who loved me and who gave himself for me. Now think about this. If I feel this tormented about losing my earthly identity, how do you feel when you haven't found your heavenly identity for a while? Do you feel okay when there's an absence in your life of not being in the place where God's word is being preached? Do you feel okay with an absence of your life of not going to your knees in prayer, whether it's intercession for your family, whether it's intercession for yourself personally, whether it's intercession that God would do something? When you cannot find the core essence of Jesus in your life, do you begin to freak out? Because if I feel this way about my earthly identity, man, how much more should I feel about my heavenly identity? You see, Paul says that even though I'm crucified with Christ, so Paul's saying, I identify with the crucifixion of Jesus Christ, which means I crucified with Christ. I'm dead. Nick Griffin is dead, but nevertheless, I'm alive. But it's not me that's alive, it's Christ that lives in me. And now, the life which I now live in the flesh, I live through the faith of the Son of God, who loved me and who gave himself for me. What he's saying is this: Nick Griffin is dead. Nick Griffin has wronged people. Nick Griffin has been a dirtbag from time to time to time to time. But I put Nick Griffin on the cross of Calvary. I put him to death. And I began to move from who he is into the essence, but I'm alive. But nevertheless, it's not me, but it's Christ in me. Now, everything that Nick Griffin does and everything that Nick Griffin says is all what Jesus did and is all what Jesus says. I began to amass a new identity of not being a part of the former things who Nick Griffin represented previously, but now I begin to move into identifying with the fullness of who Jesus is. People are being discouraged. Just speak how Jesus spoke to them. People have no hope. You speak as Jesus spoke to them. People are wrestling with legalism. You speak about what Jesus said about legalism. If you find yourself unloving, speak the love. God is love. Jesus is love. Identify with the essence of who he is. There are many people who walk around with a spiritual fake ID. They have an ID, they've taken this ID, and they've mismanaged it in multiple different ways that was never the intention of what God had. Well, how do you know those people? You'll know them by their fruits, Jesus says. You'll know them by their demeanor, the things they say. From the abundance in the heart, the mouth speaks. If there's wickedness in the heart, the mouth will speak wickedness. If there's love in the heart, the mouth will speak love. Well, that's great, Nick, but what do I do? I think it's easy, and then we're completely done with this video. To the church of Ephesus, Jesus said this. He said, I know your works, your labor, your love, your patience. He said, you can't even stand those who are evil. He also goes on to say, you've tried those who said that they're apostles and they're not, which means that you know church doctrine better than anybody. And you're patient again, but nevertheless, you've lost your first love. Excuse me, you left your first love. He said, remember, therefore, from whence you are fallen, repent and do the former things. If your identity today is found in anything else other than Christ, if you've lost or seemingly lost your spiritual inheritance, I can't find my wallet until God reveals where it is. But today you can retake your spiritual inheritance, your spiritual identity back by simply saying, God, I repent from not loving the place of the congregation of the assembly of your people, for not loving the words being spoken by a man, Lord, who simply is declaring what your word says, not his self-imposed legalistic ideology. God, I repent from what I'm doing, what I'm finding identity in otherwise. God, and I go back to the former places where I once had a love for you that was so pure, that was so holy, and I was so enraptured by who you were and the essence of what you were doing. You have to backtrack. I've been backtracking all day to find my wallet. I went to 3 different businesses, okay? I can't find my wallet anywhere. I've been backtracking to it. Nobody loses their first love. They left it somewhere. My wallet's not lost. It's misplaced. It's somewhere where it shouldn't be. Reclaim your spiritual authority. Reclaim your identity in Jesus Christ again today. It's going to take humility. And it's going to take repentance. Simply saying, Lord, I submit myself under your will. Bring back to me the things, the former things. Lord, show me the love that you have for me again. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. I love you guys. Keep strong in the faith. Keep fighting in the faith. There will be a crown of glory laid up for you, I promise. In Jesus' name, amen.